Welcome to Department of Electronics and Telecommunication at Vidya Alankar Institute of Technology. In this department, we have taken this new initiative to start our own YouTube channel. In this YouTube channel, we are going to upload all our experiments video, value-added course video, or any other important videos. This material will be available to all the students in Mumbai University, and this material will help students to enhance their learning, not just in their classroom, but even outside the classroom. I hope that everyone will like this our effort, and in case of any query, comments, anything, they can put it in comment box. Thank you.
Welcome to VLSI Lab. Now we are going to discuss about NAND operation and the implementation of NAND using CMOS. Before the implementation of NAND using CMOS, first two things we need to learn are the operations of AND and OR. In order to implement PMOS in NAND, for NAND operation, PMOS are connected in parallel and NMOS in series. On the other hand, for OR, PMOS are connected in, is connected in series and NMOS in parallel. So as we can see here, of NAND, as you know, the CMOS inverter gives an inverted output, so we consider only A dot B. Now since A dot B is a NAND operation, the PMOS is connected in parallel. On the other hand, NMOS is connected in series, and the output is obtained at the junction of PMOS and NMOS. That is why.
So we consider the direction from A to B. Hence we write S1 D1 D2 S2, and in NMOS we consider again A to B, so D3 S3 D4 S4. So from the circuit diagram we can see that S1 and S2 are connected to VDD. Hence through contact S1 and S2 are connected to VDD. Similar to that, S4 is connected to ground, so S4 is connected to ground through the contact. Now the output is obtained at the junction of D1, D2 and D3. Since D1 and D2 are combined here, D3 is taken from here and the output is provided. And the dotted line here represents the NVEL.
So now we are going to implement NAND operation using CMOS on microwind. So first we take the metal. So metal layer is constructed. Now referring the stick diagram, we are going to draw P diffusion, which is yellow. So the P diffusion is constructed. Now we are going to draw NVEL. Constructed. Now we are going to draw N diffusion. This is the N diffusion. We'll draw another metal. The metal layer is constructed. This now let us construct the polysilicon through which we are going to give our input. The polysilicons are constructed. As we have two inputs, so we have two polysilicon. Contacts are given. Now we are going to give the inputs to the polysilicon. In order to give the input, we select add clock from the palette, assign it. This is input A. Now next, input B. Okay. We need to give VDD and ground to the metal. So by selecting VDD from the palette, now selecting ground on the palette, so VDD and ground are given. Now output is assigned by selecting visible load from the palette, and the output is assigned. VDD is assigned in the NVEL. The NAND using CMOS. Now let us run and verify. So this is the layout of the NAND using CMOS. Now we are going to run. So run simulation. So this is the output obtained. This is our input A and this is our input B. For input 00 we get output as 1. For input 10 we get output 1. For input 01 we get output 1. Hence it is verified. So this is the circuit diagram, stick diagram and the layout of NAND. Thank you for watching.